don't think that they are advanced. Now, regarding strategic implantology, of course, this discipline or this method gets criticism. No? Some say that that we are breaking the rules. We are breaking the rules of implantology. Is this true? Others say, okay, is this really an improvement or is this really an innovation? Well, my answer is, strategic implantology is a substitution. So this technology will substitute the present implantology. I'm quite sure, and in many countries, this technology already has reached the tipping point, so there is no way back. I have never seen it that an implantologist who has been learning this technology and who has started to work with this technology, that he ever came back to two-stage implantology. This is simply, it's not happening. I mean, if this would happen, then this guy or this lady simply wouldn't have understood the basics. Bone, and the lecture is intended to be seen by dental implantologists, because I feel that implantologists do not know the basics of bone. We all have learned about bone, of course, in our university times, but we have learned it from the point of view of an anatomist or of a physiologist, but we have not heard information about bone from implantology. I want to show you this on this model. Conventional dental implant consists out of a bone-anchored implant body. The implant has a large diameter and the surface inside the bone is rough. The surface is then inserted into the bone until this line. Unfortunately, the bone shrinks after the insertion of the implants, and this means that even under normal circumstances, it means always rough surfaces are going to be exposed to the oral cavity. The rough surface of the implant will be exposed already after 6 to 9 months in the mouth, and the inflammation begins. This persistent inflammation and further bone loss often ends up in the loss of the implant. There are, however, implants available which prevent this problem. In these implants, we see a different design. The first difference is that the mucosal penetration zone is smooth and very thin. The second difference is that these implants are manufactured including abutment, so the implants are made from one piece. And the third big difference, these implants are fully polished. For these implants, it does not matter how much the bone may atrophy or shrink later on, a peri-implantitis will never appear. These implants are not only safer, they also allow an improved treatment protocol.